what's up, you guys, and welcome back to Gal. If you guys are new here, I do weekly video editing, photo, and audio tutorials to help you guys create better. Now, most of the time I'm at my desktop and I'm using Premiere Pro or another advanced software tool that requires you to sit at your desk. Now, if you're just looking to create some short social video for your Instagram or Facebook or Twitter, you don't really need to use advanced software for that. And I recently discovered this free new tool on your app, and it's called PRISM. Now this app, I did a whole video about how you can use it to stream high quality video to YouTube, but with the tool, I discovered there's a hidden editing tool inside of it. So if you film some video on your phone and you want to quickly edit it together, or if you have some footage from your DSLR camera and you want to bring it over to your camera roll and save it and edit it, you can use that tool to do that. So you can trim the video, you can add transitions, you can apply a VHS overlay, some stickers, some text. You can do all of this with a free app on your phone. So no need to go sit at your desk, edit in Premiere Pro. If you wanna do that, you can totally do that. I have tons of tutorials that you guys can follow on how to edit on your computer. But the reason why I bring this up is a lot of times I'm in the situation myself where I just wanna be able to quickly edit on my phone and not have to go to my computer, whip it out and export it and then save it to my camera roll. It's just like a lot of different steps, right? But with PRISM, you just literally edit it and you can save it to your camera roll, or you could directly post it to social from the app. So what I've done is I've reached out to the kind folks at PRISM and they've sponsored this video, and I'm going to walk through the entire app to show you guys from start to finish how to edit a little short video. And I hope you guys find it useful. And yeah, let's go ahead and jump on in. So after you download the PRISM Live Studio app, just click on the app here and it will open up and you can see the video of me here. There's video mode, to the right there's photo, and there's also live mode if you want to stream live. But we're going to use the video mode here, and if you do not want to record, which you can right now, you can actually access video from your camera roll. So I'm going to tap on the camera roll icon on the left here, and this is where you can choose video from your camera roll, and the order in which you select them will be the order in which they are laid out in your timeline. And then I'm going to click on add up at the top, and then it will actually merge all the clips together into one long video clip that you can save to your camera roll, or you can share directly with somebody. But this is where the secret tool is. If you click up on edit at the top, this is where you can actually edit and add effects and music. So you can see here, as I scrub through, all the edit points are here, this little white portion. So you can see it goes to the next clip and the next clip. Now, before I trim them down, I wanted to show you that you can use the crop tool here to actually change the aspect ratio. So you can use square, 4:5, 4:3, and vertical over here on the left, and you just pinch to resize them. But in this case, I'll just use the 16:9 and hit the check mark. That's all good. Now this is where it really shines. PRISM has a music library that you can choose from. So you can click on music and then you can browse for music, and all this music doesn't have any copyright issues. So if you use this, you won't get any copyright strikes, which is really awesome. Or if you have a particular track in mind, of course you can go to music that's on your device. But in this case, I'm just going to choose A Breath of Fresh Air and it will start to play. And you can choose different durations. So because I'm going to edit a 15-second video for Instagram, I'll just tap 15 seconds and then I'll hit add. And now you can see the audio waveform here, and just hit the check mark. And now when we play it back, you'll hear audio, the music, with video. So what we can do now is scrub through and we can start to trim and split clips. Let's play it back and I can hit pause when I want to cut. So right here, I want to make a cut. Now there's a couple ways that you can do this. You can select the clip and you can see the yellow handles. And what I can do is just roll this back to the moment I want to trim it to make it smaller. Or what I can do is, again, we can listen back to where I want to cut. So right here, if I wanted to make the cut, I can hit the split icon right here and it will split the clip.
And then I can delete this portion and it makes a cut that way. So what I'll do is I'll just quickly go through and trim all the clips down, and then I will show you how to add transitions. And if you wanted to change the order of a clip, you can just tap, hold, and then move it over and drop it in between clips, which is super cool. I'm just wrapping up my trimming here, and I'm just gonna roll this edit back to be exactly 15 seconds and hit the check mark. So let me just go back to the beginning and hit play so you can see how I trimmed the video to end when the music ends at 15 seconds. So that's the video here. Now let's go ahead and add some transitions. So this is where it gets really cool. At this edit point here, if you just tap on it, just like that, you can choose a different transition. So we can add a fade transition. So you can see what that looks like by scrubbing through. We can add another fade here. Let's add another fade. And then they have movement transitions. So we can try up and then we can try down. So now let's play it back to see how the transitions look. So it looks pretty good. If you need to edit these transitions, you can tap and hold on this and you can change the duration. So if you want it to be a half of a second instead of a second, you can do that. And let's go ahead and tap on this one and let's tap on that. Let's also make that half a second. All right, great. So now that we have transitions, now let's look at filters. So this is where you tap on the three little circles here. And this is where you can apply different filters to the individual clips. So you can scrub through here and you can see a bunch of different looks. And the ones that I like are the film looks here. So if you just tap, you can see the different film filters you can apply. And these are all built in, you don't have to purchase them. I think I'm gonna go with number 2 here. And then we can just tap to apply them to all of the different clips. All right, that's looking good. And now for special effects, this is where you can click on this icon here. I'm not quite sure what it looks like. It's two circles and one circle has stripes, so just tap on that. And this is my favorite effect, is you can go to the beginning. And the way that these work is you just tap and hold for as long as you want the effect applied. So this is just a visual look, and the first one is a VHS effect. So if I just tap and hold, the yellow part is where the effect is applied. So the entire portion here is now in a VHS effect, and all we had to do was just tap and hold. So hit check. And you can see here that I accidentally applied two of them separately. So what you can do is actually tap on that one and hit the trash. And then for this one, we can just extend it out so it extends to the length of the video and hit the check mark there. So now you can see that we have a filter by that blue marker on top. We have transitions. And it's looking pretty good. At the end here, this is where I like to put a call to action. And this is where you can actually add a cool sticker that's animated. So if you hit on that icon that's like a finger tapping, you can choose any one of these animated overlays here. So if we choose subscribe, it'll say just tap on the screen. That looks awesome. So then hit check. And then if you want to type out custom text, you can just scroll over all the way to the right and hit the text icon. And this is where I will just hit plus text and I'll just type the YouTube channel, youtube.com/premieregal. And I will change it to be a little bit smaller. And this really reminds me of Instagram, which is why it's so intuitive. And then if you click on the type tool up here at the top, you can give it a background and you can change the color and the size. You can scale it up just by pinching and making it bigger, rotating it, however you like. The little yellow line indicates that it's straight. If you tap on it again, you can change the color. Let's change it to black. Let's see how that looks. That's looking pretty good. And then here, the handles, you can choose the duration of the text. So after subscribe animates out, we'll have the text come in. And then hit check. So now you can see we have a filter, we have some cool VHS effects, lots of transitions, we have an animation and text, and it just took a couple of minutes. So let's just play it back to see how it looks. So just that simple, we made a short social video that we could share about this little skateboarding experience, and the same you can do for your travel experiences or your vlogging. And then once you're done, you can just hit save, and you can hit the save icon to save it to your camera roll, and it starts to encode it. And of course, it's at a 1080p resolution, but you can always change that later on. Or if you want to, you can hit share. So you can share it to Instagram, Facebook, Facebook Messenger, messages, and more. So you can add different apps that you like. And lastly, just two quick things. If you click on the profile icon in the upper right, down below, you can see all of your current video editing projects, and you can tap on the ellipsis to rename them or delete them. Or if you want to continue editing, just tap on it and get started. And if you go up to the top, if you click on the gear icon next to your name, down here underneath general, this is where you can choose to hide the PRISM watermark. So when you're done with your video and you don't want the PRISM watermark on, just make sure that this is yellow. If it's off, it will have a watermark, and it's completely free to conceal your watermark, which is really awesome.
So that's all there is to getting started in PRISM. If you guys have any questions at all, be sure to leave a comment below and give this video a thumbs up if you want to try it out. And I'm sure the PRISM team will take in any feedback that you guys have, any recommendations for filters that you guys would like to see in the app. Just leave a comment below. Anywho, that is all for this video, and I look forward to seeing you guys next week. Bye.